Respiratory therapy school definitely is not easy. Students are under pressure from day one to make good grades, finish homework, complete projects, and perform well during clinical rotations. Needless to say, RT students have to deal with their fair share of stress, while trying to avoid feeling overwhelmed. With that said, we have a few tips that can make your life easier as you navigate your way through respiratory therapy school, which is what we're going to share in this video. So if you're ready, let's get into it. Tip number one is to know your why. The first step to being successful in respiratory therapy school is knowing why you're pursuing this career. What's the reason you decided to enroll in the first place? Do you want to help others? Do you want to save lives? Are you looking for a fulfilling career that also provides a respectable salary? You must have a strong reason for why you want to be a respiratory therapist because, let's face it, it's not an easy profession. If your why is strong enough, it'll be much easier to push through the challenging moments through respiratory therapy school. Tip number two is to study a little every day. One of the best ways to stay on top of your coursework is to study a little bit each day. Sure, there are times when it's necessary to spend hours preparing for an exam. However, that's not always the case. Sometimes it's much more beneficial to study a few minutes each day rather than trying to cram everything in the night before the exam. Number three is to get organized. One of the best ways to be successful in respiratory therapy school is to stay organized. Get a planner and write down all of your assignments, exams, and clinical rotations. This will help you keep track of everything you need to do and make sure you don't forget anything important. If your materials are cluttered, your brain will be too, which will only make it harder on yourself. So, keep your desk clean and your thoughts clear by staying organized. Tip number four, don't skip classes. It may be tempting to skip a class here and there, especially if you have a lot of other things going on outside of school. However, it's very important to try to attend all of your classes. The first step to success is simply showing up. You never know when you'll learn something important or when an exam will be announced. Next up is to know your learning style. Everyone learns differently. Some students learn best by listening to lectures, while others retain information better by reading texts or taking notes. Find out what learning style works best for you, and then try to find ways to incorporate that style into your studies. If listening to lectures helps you learn, try recording them or taking notes. If reading text is more your style, try highlighting important information or making flashcards. If you're a visual learner, you'll benefit from watching educational videos on the topic at hand, which is probably how you ended up here watching this video. If so, the good news is that our YouTube channel is packed with hundreds of helpful videos that cover some of the most important topics that RT students must learn. So definitely be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Number six, don't procrastinate. Sometimes it can be tempting to put off studying or doing homework, but it's important to try to avoid procrastination. The longer you wait to do something, the more difficult it will become. There's nothing worse than trying to cram for an exam the night before you finish a project that's due in a few hours. If you start working on something early, you'll have more time to complete it, and you'll likely do a better job. Decreased stress is an added bonus. The next tip on our list is to rewrite your notes. One of the most effective learning strategies that we've noticed over the years happens when students rewrite their notes. This may seem tedious, but it's actually a proven method for helping increase information retention. When you take the time to rewrite your notes, you're essentially reinforcing what you learned so that it's easier for your brain to recall the information later on. So when test day comes, you'll be better prepared and more likely to earn a passing score thanks to your diligent note rewriting habits. Tip number eight is to crush it one night per week. One way to make studying more manageable is to set aside one night per week where you focus exclusively on schoolwork. There should be no distractions, and you can sit down, focus, and study relentlessly for a period of time. This will help you stay on top of your coursework and ensure that you're prepared for your exams. If you can use this one night to get ahead on your work, you'll have more free time throughout the week. This will help you avoid feeling overwhelmed, which is great for your mental health. The next tip on our list is to simply ask for help. If you're struggling with a particular concept or have questions about an assignment, it's okay to ask for help. There's no shame in admitting that you need assistance. Your professors, classmates, and the respiratory therapist zone community are here to help you succeed. It's better to ask for help than to struggle through something on your own. By seeking assistance, you can get the guidance you need to improve your understanding of the material. Tip number 10, don't stress over the small stuff. In the grand scheme of things, a low score on one test or a bad grade in one class is not going to make or break your career. Of course, you should still strive to do your best, but don't let the little things get to you. Everyone makes mistakes and has bad days. The important thing is to learn from your mistakes and keep moving forward. If you dwell on your failures, you'll only make it harder to achieve success. Tip 11 is to form a study group. For some, one of the best ways to prepare for exams is to form a study group with your classmates. When you meet with other students, you can discuss the material, share study tips, and help each other identify areas that need improvement. Plus, it's more enjoyable to study with friends. Just be sure to choose a study group that is serious about getting work done. However, of course, this isn't for everyone, as some students prefer to study alone. But if you work well in groups, this could be a helpful strategy for you. The next tip that we should mention is to get plenty of sleep. As a respiratory therapist student, sleep is very important for your overall health and well-being. Sleep deprivation can lead to increased levels of stress, which can make it more difficult to concentrate and retain essential information. Therefore, it's important to get enough sleep so that you'll have enough energy to make it through your lectures and clinical rotations. Tip number 13 is simple. Don't forget to take breaks. If you find yourself struggling to focus, it may be helpful to step away from your work and take a quick break. Go for a walk, listen to music, or do something that will help you relax. This can refresh your mind and help you return to your work feeling rejuvenated. Just be sure to keep your breaks short so you don't fall too far behind on your work. Tip number 14 is to create a schedule. One way to stay on top of your studies is to create a schedule and stick to it. By setting aside specific times for studying, you can make sure that you're dedicating enough time to your schoolwork. Plus, having a set schedule will help you avoid feeling overwhelmed by your coursework and everything else that respiratory therapy students have to deal with. Trust me, a schedule is your best friend. Tip number 15 is to set goals. In addition to creating a schedule, it'll also be helpful to set goals for yourself. For example, you could aim to read one chapter of your textbook each day or complete all of your assignments for the week by Friday. Setting goals can help you stay on track and motivated. Plus, it's always satisfying to achieve something that you've been working towards. The next tip on our list is to reward yourself. Once you've achieved a goal, be sure to give yourself a pat on the back. You deserve it. You could treat yourself to a new book, take a break from studying to watch your favorite TV show, or go out for drinks with your friends. No matter what you choose to do, make sure it's something that you'll enjoy. After you put in the work, it's actually a great idea to give yourself a reward because what gets rewarded gets repeated. Tip number 17 is very important, and it is to use practice questions. If you want to be fully prepared for your exams, you should use practice questions to your advantage. This is one of the most effective methods for learning and retaining important information. This is true not only for your exams in RT school, but it also applies to the TMC exam as well. In fact, our bank of practice questions has already helped millions of students worldwide prepare for and pass the exam. So, do yourself a favor and use practice questions to study and learn the information that will be covered on your exams. Tip number 18 is to avoid cramming. When it comes to studying, cramming is almost never a good idea. Cramming the night before an exam is not only ineffective, but it can also lead to increased levels of stress. Plus, when you try to cram everything into your brain at once, you're more likely to forget some of the most important information. So instead of cramming, study gradually and consistently throughout the semester. This will help you retain the information better and make exam day a lot less stressful. Tip number 19 is to implement the 80-20 principle. The 80-20 principle is a powerful tool that is used to increase your productivity. Simply put, the principle states that 80% of your results comes from 20% of your efforts. So, how can you use this to your advantage? Well, instead of spending all your time studying every topic, it may be better to focus more on the areas that will give you the most bang for your buck. For example, there are more questions on the TMC exam about mechanical ventilation than any other topic. Therefore, it would make sense to spend more time focusing on this topic than on subjects that aren't quite as heavily weighted. The 80-20 principle can be applied to just about anything in your life, so make sure to use it to your advantage. Tip number 20 is to start early. One of the best pieces of advice I can give you is to start preparing for the board exams as early as possible. There's a ton of information that you will be required to know. Therefore, the sooner you start studying, the better. Even if it's in small bursts, every little bit helps. For example, we have a newsletter that sends out sample TMC practice questions to our students on a daily basis. The questions cover all of the most important topics that you are required to know for passing the exam, including topics that, unfortunately, some students forget to study. So, by starting early and going through these practice questions every day, students are able to learn and retain helpful tidbits of information over time. This adds up to huge results in the long run. If you're interested in signing up, I'll drop a link down below in the description. And last but not least, tip number 21 is to make sure that you take advantage of free resources. There are a ton of free resources available to respiratory therapy students, so why not take advantage of them? For instance, we've spent thousands of hours creating a ton of free practice questions and study guides for our students. It would be wise to use them to your advantage. Not to mention the hundreds of free educational videos here on our YouTube channel. Like plenty of other students, you can use our free materials to pass your exams in school while learning the most important information. This will even help you pass the board exams to become a licensed respiratory therapist whenever the time comes. I mean, what more could you ask for? If you want to support the channel, be sure to like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you'll enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we're not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching, have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.